हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी. वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज़ एपिसोड 76.
ओला हैज अनाउंस्ड दैट इट विल सून स्टार्ट हेल्पिंग यूजर्स प्रोक्योर ऑक्सीजन कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड बाय प्रोवाइडिंग अ फ्यू बेसिक डिटेल्स. आफ्टर द डिटेल्स आर वैलिडेटेड, द कंपनी विल डिलीवर द ऑक्सीजन कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड टू द यूजर्स डोरस्टेप फ्री ऑफ चार्ज. टू प्रोवाइड दिस सर्विस, द ओला फाउंडेशन हैज पार्टनर्ड विद द गिवन इंडियन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. द सर्विस विल स्टार्ट रोलिंग आउट इन बैंगलोर नेक्स्ट वीक एंड इट विल एक्सपैंड अक्रॉस इंडिया इन द कमिंग वीक्स. Flipkart has introduced a new flagship fest on its site offering smartphone at a reduced rate thanks to the deals and discount attached to it. The flagship fest has already begun and will go on till May 14th. The 5-day sale will see phones like iPhone 11, iPhone 12 range and Samsung Galaxy F62 be listed with deals and discount. The e-commerce site is partnered with Citibank to offer 10% instant discount on the credit and debit cards. It is also offering extra ₹500 off on EMI transaction on products above 20,000 rupees. PUBG Mobile India. Krafton last week announced Battlegrounds Mobile India. The upcoming game is the PUBG Mobile India that users were waiting for in the country. Krafton did not announce the official release date of its upcoming Battle Royale in India. A new report now claims that Krafton is planning to release Battlegrounds Mobile India in June. Oppo today launched its official e-commerce store in India with over 80 merchandise throughout finance and premium smartphones, IoT merchandise and wearables. In addition to its online store launch, the Chinese company brought introductory deals and offers under a grand opening sale. The offers that are live under the grand opening sale via Oppo e-store will be valid until May 17th. Amazon has published its first ever brand protection report detailing a self-audit list of numbers and measures that it has taken in order to counter the presence of fake products on the platform. This e-commerce giant has taken in order to reduce issues of counterfeit products and sellers on its platform. Over 6 million new sellers accounts and 10 billion suspected products were banned from listing on the platform. Starting this year, Amazon will offer seller address to increase consumer trust. Amazon claims that less than 1 in 10,000 products sold on its platform globally receive fake product complaints. Facebook has unveiled a raft of new messaging features across Messenger, Instagram, Direct and Messenger kits. With new themed stickers and background, visual replies and a read receipts on IG, improved audio call recording tools and an updated archive feature. None of these new tools is groundbreaking necessarily, but they do all add something extra which could be helpful in your interactive process. Clubhouse finally has an Android application that you can download from the Play Store provided you live in the US. The voice-based social network launched its beta Android application on the Play Store for users in the US on Sunday and said it will be gradually make the new application available in other English-speaking countries and then the rest of the world. Sennheiser and the Sonova Holding AG with headquarters in Stafa, Switzerland have announced their future cooperation under the Sennheiser brand. The global provider of medical hearing solution will fully take over the Sennheiser consumer electronic business subject to regulatory approval. The plan is to complete the transfer of the business to Sonova by the end of the 2021. Sennheiser has announced in February that it would focus on the professional business in the future while seeking a partner for the consumer electronic business. Tesla announced that it has invested $1.5 billion in Bitcoin and has also revealed that it would start accepting Bitcoin as payment for buying its car. Now another Elon Musk LED company is following the suit. SpaceX will be launching the Dogi 1 mission to the moon in the first quarter of next year, and the company will be accepting cryptocurrency Dogecoin as payment, revealed by Elon Musk in a tweet. LG Innotek, a company that makes smartphone parts such as mini vibration motor, LCD modules, LED, camera modules, protection circuit modules, and it is selling its patented equipment related to its LED business to a China-based LED company. As per the report, the South Korean company will key out equipment related to LED at its Paju plant within 1 month. The company will be handing over more than 10,000 patents related to LED to the Chinese firm. It has been said that the LG initiated talks to sell its LED patents and equipment for 100 billion won in turnkey fashion. LG has invested heavily in the LED business, especially in the ultraviolet LED area, which is likely the reason for the deal to go through. Experts believe that LG could have licensed UV LED patent instead of selling them. The TV consoles are getting a lot more powerful than earlier as the requirement for gaming keeps on increasing. The newly announced Apple TV 4K is powered by an A12 Bionic chipset, doesn't live up to the expectations, and indicates that the tech giant is not focusing on a gaming performance. However, it now seems that company is working on a new portable hybrid console for gaming, which will be powered by a new chipset with performance improvement and enhanced graphics processing. A Korean community claims that the upcoming hybrid portable console from Apple will be similar to the Nintendo Switch. This means that Apple is now looking to have a product that directly targets gamers. Laptops like the recent Galaxy Book Go run Windows 10 on a Qualcomm Snapdragon chipset. However, according to the reports, Samsung will introduce a new Exynos chipset in the second half of the year that will be used to power future laptops. These chips, tentatively named as Exynos 2200, will feature an AMD Ryzen GPU which will deliver a PC-class graphics performance. This chip will be faded at Samsung's 5-nanometer foundries. Xiaomi patent a new smartphone with a unique camera design. The patent revealed a handset with a camera module that had a thunderbolt-like design on the rear side. The patent was filed by a Chinese smartphone maker back in October 2020, which was published last month on April 20, 2021. Let's Go Digital has discovered yet another interesting patent by Xiaomi. As per the details published by Let's Go Digital, Xiaomi has patented a smartphone with a rotating underscreen camera. This patent was filed by Xiaomi back in Feb 2020 with the World Intellectual Property Organization. Xiaomi bought Mi A2 Pro back in October, but now the true wireless earphones are getting a successor. Revealing a new case with the new Xiaomi logo on the hing, the image also tells us when the launch will take place this Thursday, May 13th. Meanwhile, a leakster posted an image of the actual buds which will have a rubber tips. The Department of Telecommunications had recently approved the application from telecom companies for conducting 5G trials in India. Telcos were supposed to begin 5G trials in India in the upcoming months. However, a couple of days later post an approval, the trials were reportedly pushed to Q1 2022. The report claimed that the DoT wants to prioritize a stable network during the pandemic and hence put out decisions on spectrum availability and pricing. The latest development is hinting a further delay in the 5G rollout in India. Google India has announced that Google Maps is testing a new feature that will help users to share information on medical oxygen and available hospital beds directly via the application. The software giant explained that the feature will be available in the form of question and answer that would enable people to ask about to share local information on the availability of beds and medical oxygen in selected location. Google adds that end users may be required to verify the accuracy and freshness of the information before utilizing it. As this is will be a user-generated content and not provided by any authorized sources. Poco F3 GT has been listed for sale ahead of the official launch of the smartphone. The phone's price is listed at a whopping $1,229, that is approximately 95,300 Indian rupees. The key specifications include a 6.7-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display, MediaTek Dimensity 1200 processor. It runs on 64-megapixel primary camera at the rear and it also has a 5,065 mAh battery. Asus ZenFone 8 Series India launch have been confirmed. However, the launch is delayed owing to COVID-19 crisis in the country. ZenFone 8 Series is expected to come with a Snapdragon 888 processor and up to 120Hz AMOLED display and it runs on Android 11 as its OS. Bolt Audio has launched its AirBase FX1 True Wireless Earbuds in India placed at ₹1,499. These earbuds will be available in three colors including black, white and blue. The AirBase FX1 is already available for purchase on Amazon India. These earbuds have touch controls for easy playback controls and voice assistant access as well. Japan is opening its first ever esports gym in Tokyo where people can book 3-hour slots at PCs and pay for coaching from professional gamers. This will include a lounge and gaming PCs outfit with some of the Japan's most popular games including Valorant and League of Legends. Gamer can book a 3-hour time slot at one of the PCs for about $13 or opt for monthly membership starting at $50 which allow daily access to the gaming PCs as well as optional coaching sessions that can be added on for about $25 per hour. After teasing its Lenovo YogaPad Pro 13 last week, Lenovo has now revealed the launch date of its upcoming tablet. The device is set to be announced on May 24th in China. The latest teaser also confirmed the Pad Pro will bring a quad speaker setup with Dolby Atmos housed in the tubular kickstand. Right from giants like Facebook and Google to startups such as HealthifyMe introduced a slew of tools over the past few weeks to help people find slots for vaccination appointments. Snapdeal said that it has created an easy-to-use platform Sanjeevani to use its wide reach in India including across smaller towns and cities to connect people. The tool will be accessible via the website and a mobile application, it added. Patients and donors can register themselves with their mobile number, email IDs and can provide relevant information like blood group, location and donor-specific details such as when they tested positive or negative for COVID-19 infection. After registering, Snapdeal search engine will look for relevant matches and connect patients with potential donors. Sanjeevani was first launched to help the employees of Snapdeal find possible donors, but the e-commerce platform has now opened this for everyone. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.